Hello, Karen Bradley says she is profoundly sorry for her statement to the House of Commons about security force killings. She began yesterday by saying they were not crimes, and despite trying to clarify her remarks later today, she admitted her language was wrong. During that time, the number of calls for her resignation has increased, ranging from the ex-Ulster Unionist leader Mike Nesbitt to the former police ombudsman Nuala O'Loan. I spoke to Karen Bradley earlier this evening and I began by asking her if she accepts that she's now fighting for her ministerial life.
Well, what I accept is that yesterday I said something in answer to an oral question that was wrong. I shouldn't have said it. I corrected the record as soon as I could, and I want to apologise to everybody who has been hurt or distressed by what I said. It was, as I say, it was wrong. I should not have said it. But what I do want to do now is make sure that I deliver for those families from all parts of the community who have been so deeply affected by the Troubles, because I know how raw that pain is, and it makes me I'm devastated to think that I have made it worse.
However, you have said what you said. Are you now considering your position?
As I say, I said something in response to an oral question, and as soon as I realised what I had said, I corrected the record. I did not mean to say it in that way. It was odd, or at all. I did not mean to say it. It's not what I think. It's not what I mean. So I said something wrong and I have apologised, and now I want to get on and deliver for those families.
The former police ombudsman Baroness O'Loan says you have demonstrated yet again that you are not fit to be the Secretary of State. That is a damning indictment of your time in office, isn't it?
Well, I am working incredibly hard for the people of Northern Ireland. I've worked tirelessly since I was appointed to what I consider to be one of the greatest honours in government, to be Secretary of State for Northern Ireland. I am determined that we'll restore devolution and that we will deliver things like the city deals.
Yeah, but no, the question is whether or not you're up to the job.
Well, I'm absolutely determined that I will deliver. As I say, I said something I shouldn't have said. I fully accept that I shouldn't have said it. It was wrong, and I've apologised.
Yeah, and you've said that and you've made that very clear. But still, nonetheless, there are a lot of people who are very annoyed at what you said and who don't think that you're capable of doing the job in future. The former Ulster Unionist Party leader, Mike Nesbitt, said you've consistently demonstrated you are not up to the job. How do you recover from that kind of comment?
Well, I work incredibly hard and I deliver for the people of Northern Ireland. That's what I do, and that's what I am determined to do.
Will you go back to the House of Commons and formally apologise to MPs?
Well, I've made a statement on the record correcting what I said.
Yeah, but you didn't apologise in the House.
And in terms of what I've done, that is a great statement. I have made an apology to those...
Tony Lloyd says that's not enough. He says you've got to go back. The Shadow Secretary of State for Northern Ireland says you need to go back into the House and apologise and set out the government's legacy policy. And if you don't do that, you can't continue in your job.
Well, on the legacy policy, we consulted on legacy, a consultation that took many years to get out, and I was, again, as Secretary of State, determined we should get out. We received over 17,000 responses, and these are detailed personal responses that take time to go through, and we are making sure we take the time to go through every single one of them. When we have been through the consultation responses and are able to come back with the what's come out from the consultation and next steps, I will, of course, do that.
How do you restore the confidence of the nationalist community in particular in Northern Ireland? A lot of people are upset and offended by what you said and think you've made a dog's breakfast of it, frankly, but the nationalist community in particular has lost confidence in you. How do you try to fix that?
As I say, I said something I shouldn't have said.
No, you've told me that. I'm asking you, how do you restore the confidence of the nationalist community?
And I've apologised for saying that, and I will work night and day to make sure I deliver on those things that people are concerned about, and I will make sure I deliver for those families, because that is the best way.
They now don't have any confidence in you. That's the very point. Let me ask you this question. When you stood up in the House of Commons yesterday, did you intend to say that 10% of killings carried out by members of the security forces were not crimes?
No, I've said...
So that was a mistake?
I did not intend to say that. I have said what I said was wrong, and I have been quite open about that.
So the implications of what you said are very, very clear. If you didn't intend to say that, but said it anyway, that's a problem. If you didn't realise the implications of what you were saying, that is also a problem. I mean, either way, you're in a very awkward position here.
There are no excuses for what I said yesterday, and I'm not making any excuses.
So the point is, you either knew what you were saying and said it anyway, or you didn't know what you were saying. Either of those is pretty bad for a Secretary of State who claims to be on top of her brief.
I said something in the heat of an oral question session, which I said, I said the wrong thing. I corrected the record at the earliest opportunity, and I've apologised to those people that I have hurt. And I'm devastated to think that something that I said that I didn't intend, and I do not believe, has hurt people in that way.
So how did you say it? If you didn't intend to say it, and it isn't what you think, how did you say it?
Because I said the wrong thing. There's no getting away from that. I said the wrong thing.
You said the wrong thing, and then you compounded it further. You said that those 10% of killings were not crimes. You then went further, and you said they were carried out by people who were acting under orders and instructions, fulfilling their duties in a dignified and appropriate way. That sounds like something that's been carefully thought through.
I think that, as the former Prime Minister David Cameron said during the bloody statement, and in June 2010, when he made that statement and he apologised on behalf of the government, there is no defending the indefensible. And what things that were done that are indefensible should not be defended.
He said unjustified and unjustifiable. So to be clear, you are clear, state forces did commit crimes in Northern Ireland during the Troubles.
I am saying that where things happened that were unjustifiable, I am not going to try and justify them. But I'm also saying that the vast majority of those people who served during the Troubles under Operation Banner and the RUC did so in a dignified way and in an entirely lawful way.
Okay.
But where they didn't, it is absolutely right that they should face the full justice. It doesn't matter who a perpetrator is. If a crime has been committed, they should face justice.
OK, and you made that clear today in your statement. You've made it clear again that you believe in the rule of law. However, people are pointing to the fact that the Prime Minister said in the House of Commons yesterday, the MOD is looking at what more can be done to ensure that service personnel are not unfairly pursued through the courts, including considering legislation. That appears to be at odds with what you have just said. Which is it?
The position of the government is that the rule of law is something that we completely and totally abide by.
So what is the Prime Minister's position on a statute of limitations? Is that happening or not? Did she misspeak in the House of Commons yesterday?
Where crimes have happened, they should be properly investigated, no matter who the perpetrator is. As I've said, I said something I shouldn't have said. I am deeply sorry for that, and I apologise.
Yep. You have been asking people to give their views on legacy mechanisms which don't contain a statute of limitations. But in briefings to newspapers at the dispatch box yesterday, other members of the Cabinet, including the Prime Minister, are saying that is what is being considered for soldiers. Is that correct or not?
That is not what is being considered as part of the legacy consultation.
So there will be no statute of limitations?
That is not what's being considered as part of the consultation.
Well, is it being considered a number 10 outside the legacy consultation?
The government believes in the rule of law. I, as the Secretary of State and the Prime Minister, believe in the rule of law. And as I say, where a crime has been committed, it should be properly investigated by the independent prosecuting services and law enforcement, and it should be properly prosecuted.
So you would expect the government to stop speaking out of both sides of its mouth on this issue? Because that's what many people say is happening.
Well, as I say, I said something I shouldn't have said. It is not what I believe. It is not my position. I've apologised for it.
And what about Theresa May? What about her suggestion that she's trying to find a way for service personnel not to be prosecuted? That is not in line with what you've just said. That is wrong. Does she need to clarify that?
As I say, I'm talking about the Troubles in Northern Ireland. That is what I'm responsible for, and not responsible for the Troubles, I'm responsible for dealing with the legacy of the Troubles. I'm determined we will do so. And I'm determined that those families that have been hurt by what I said will see justice.
And you understand why they're hurt, and you understand why they're annoyed with you?
Absolutely.
And do you understand why they do not have confidence in you, Karen Bradley, as Secretary of State, taking this matter further forward?
Well, that's why I have to deliver for them. That's why I have to get on and make sure I deliver for them.
Or that's why you should resign?
That's why I have to deliver for them, because I'm determined that we will do.
And do you think this could be your last interview as Secretary of State for Northern Ireland?
As I say, I'm determined I will deliver for those people. I said something I shouldn't have said, and I've apologised.